Michael, it's a bit of a case of the walking winded today, was it?
Yeah, look, I mean, Munich isn't a bad result here, but I think the way the second half went, I think we deserved to go on and win it. I think we should have won it. We had the chance to win it. But sometimes just luck doesn't just go away.
I thought in the first half it was a bit of a kind of scrappy affair. Both teams looked better when they could get the ball down, but to what extent were the conditions making it difficult to do that?
Yeah, do you mean, I don't know if they could see it for the side, but the wind was a bit up in the air and it didn't have a direction to go. It was a bit swirly, but that's no excuse. We have good enough quality in our team to get the ball down and play. I think Erdre came with a plan. They just wanted to rat and it worked, and that's why they're up there as well. It works for them. They just want to play long ball stuff. We're trying to play football. We're trying to get the ball into the box, scored goals. I thought we had a great start, great goal. I'm a bit disappointed with the penalty, just not because I didn't think it was a penalty. I think we've got to do better for the free kick as well. I think we switched off at the free kick, and if we want to go and win this league, then we need to be switched on all the time. I think that was poor, but at the end of the day, we've just got to stick together now.
Harsh saying you think on Gregor, because certainly from our viewpoint, it looked like Gregor's arm was actually against his body.
Look, the rules are so... They say the rules are black and white now, but it is such a grey area. I mean, you can't chop off your arm. I mean, if your hand's by your side and it hits your arm, technically, is it a foul? Is it a penalty? Technically, yes, but I think it ruins the game a wee bit, because if you're getting the ball hit at you from a yard away, it's impossible to move your arm away. I thought actually it was outside the box as well. I feel maybe in the ref's head that he's kind of maybe tried to even it off. I wasn't 100% sure about the one with Tosh as well. Tosh has went for the ball and it's maybe a wee bit of luck there as well. And it shouldn't play in the referee's head, but I definitely think it did.
Good finish from David for the opening goal though.
Yeah, definitely. Look, the two strikers at the moment have been scoring goals. A wee bit hot and cold sometimes, but when they're in that box, they have been deadly. I say that one at the end with Decky, but I have to put my house in Decky scoring that, especially the form he's in at the moment. But we just can't rely on these two to score all the time, so we need to start finding goals from other places as well.
Lewis Toshney really unlucky with injury. It seems we're waiting to hear what's happened with him, but in a way, having the extra man in midfield when Ross McLean came on, suddenly it seemed to allow us to stretch the game a bit more. Is that fair or not?
Yeah, and I think with Toshney even on the part, the management was actually ready to change it. He said that at half time, and he felt that the formation we'd play in a wee change would have worked, and it did. I mean, Chucky came on full of confidence, got at the boy, and gave me opportunity just to back up. I thought it worked really well, and then the way the things go, Chucky gets injured as well, Ross McLean gets injured as well, and it's just one of the days when they kind of lick our wounds and hopefully kind of regroup and get all our boys back fit. I think obviously with Tosh getting injured as well, Tosh goes into everything 100 miles an hour and you wouldn't change him for that, so he's obviously had a wee slip, and these things happen in football. It's just a wee bit of luck.
In that sense, it's a little bit bittersweet in terms of we've actually moved up a place today, but ultimately the gap's now slightly wider at the top.
Yeah, look, nobody wins the league by Christmas anyway, but we want to win every game, and that's what the new management have come in and they've told us. We fight, we scratch, we dig in, we win games ugly like we did against Montrose, even though we were 2-0, we won the game. And I think there is signs of improvement that you've seen, I think, in the second half, especially from the last time we played here to that time there. Obviously, they had a couple of corners toward the end, but I think we just put so much into the game to go and win the game. And on a different day, I think we could have went 4 or 5, especially in the second half. And I'm just waiting till everything clicks and we do get that those results. But I think if we keep going the way we're going, we keep working hard, especially in training, then the tables will definitely turn for us.
And just finally, it's back to the Falkirk Stadium next week. Your thoughts on that one?
Look, we always like playing at home. It suits us so much with the big park and the way we play with the high-up wing-backs. Obviously, if we have enough players to go into the formation that the management wants, then we always enjoy playing at home, our own fans, and we get a lot of good results at home. So we're looking forward to it again. We'll lick our wins from that game there, but at the end of the day, come Monday morning, we need to concentrate on next Saturday and start picking up points going into the new year.
Here's hoping we can. Michael, yep. As always, that's your time.
Thank you very much.